Eddie had been unwell for about 2 or 3 weeks. He did end up in hospital. As soon as we went through the doors, they rushed us through. There were people waiting for us, and came back very quickly with results and said quite abruptly, this is type 1 diabetes. You were moments away from him being in a diabetic coma. And Eddie said, how long will I have it for? When will it go away? I think that was the hardest bit for me, the having to tell your own child that this isn't a cold, it's not chicken pox, it's, you know, you're going to have this forever. That was really tough.
I was 19 when I was diagnosed with diabetes. I would feel very drowsy, very tired, was losing a lot of weight. Up until we tried for children, my diabetes hadn't really been a problem. And then after I had Grace, suddenly I couldn't recognise all my hypos and my life was starting to get very narrow. Professor Johnson put me forward for the islet transplant.
Anne was having problems with severe life-threatening hyperglycemia unawareness, which is where she had absolutely no sensation when she got dangerously low blood sugar. And so at the end of 2012, she underwent her first islet transplant, and then the following year, she underwent a top-up transplant. The pancreas is an organ that sits at the back of the abdomen. A donor pancreas from an organ donor is extracted from the donor. Then the pancreas is processed, in which these islets of Langerhans are extracted from the surrounding exocrine non-islet tissue. And then those islets are transplanted into the patient with type 1 diabetes. And they start to function in a way with producing insulin and controlling the blood sugar.
Being able to have this transplant and the DRWF funding this for me led me to about 3 or 4 months later actually completely getting off insulin and having the best 5 years of my life being insulin free.
In 2017, I found out I had type 2 diabetes. I had to make some quite dramatic changes to my lifestyle. I've lost 10 stone in weight through a lot of help and support. I am now on a background insulin. I do an injection in the evening and it just keeps my blood sugars under control.
Eddie is part of the Young Athletes Club, and one of the first things he said when we were in hospital was, can I still do athletics? Immediately he said, yes, of course you can. And by which point he'd been fitted with a continuous glucose monitor in his arm. The first time back at Young Athletes Club, I was allowed down to the side of the track to make sure that Eddie was okay. And I noticed that his levels were dropping, so he needed some sugar. His alarm started going off, so I had to say, stop, come over, have jelly babies. And of course, all the other boys in his group came over. Why have you got jelly babies? I want a jelly baby. What's not fair? Why are you allowed sweets? I want sweets. And he just kind of froze. He just kept hypoing. So I had to say, we need to go and sit down. I had to walk him all the way around the track to go and sit up in the stands. And everyone's looking, and there's me with a finger monitor trying to get it to work with wet and cold hands. And then he said to me, Mummy, don't do this again. Please don't do this again. I'm fine. It can be quite a lonely place to be as a parent. And you think, why us? Why him? What do we do to deserve this? DRWF helped us in those really early hours of, what on earth is this? I think as parents, you want to solve the problem, you want to fix things. So to understand why he has it and how he got it and what it means for his future, we needed that information very quickly. And DRWF was one of the only charities that provided that information that we were able to share with others.
I started working for the Diabetes Research and Wellness Foundation in 2015. I think having that contact and understanding that there are lots of different ways that you can get support and help and learn, you don't feel like you're just battling through this on your own. The DRWF charity has a wealth of information, both on the website as hard copy patient information leaflets. We also have an online forum or group support that you might find a group local to you, or online support. So there's always somebody there.
Having a group of people really to check in and go, how are you? And for me to be able to say, well, actually, we've had a rubbish week, has been really invaluable.
I think the charity is very much at the forefront about helping people to not only understand their diabetes and to live well with it, but to feel okay about it. You can do it. I've done it. I'm still living with type 2 diabetes, but I'm living well.
I am so grateful for all those people who gave money in order to allow me to have the quality of life that I've got now. If you can give anything at all, towards this really important charity, then I please ask you to do so.